الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى. ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى في قرآنه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. الله عز وجل in this ayah in the Quran الكريم saying Muhammad is not a father of any one of you. وهذا هو تحريم التبني في الإسلام. Forbidden to adopt anyone. You can financially support. No problem with that. But to make him equal to your son or to give him your name, forbidden in Islam. But this is not my khutbah. So my khutbah about what Allah said. ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. He is Rasulullah, Messenger of Allah, the Prophet of Allah, and the end and the last and the final messenger. ولكل نبي معجزة. For every messenger there is some miracles. And our messenger, the best and the life and the continuous one from the day one till the day of judgment is Al-Quran Al-Kareem. This is number one, Al-Quran, life. And the miracles of all messengers was in the past. Our messenger, his miracle was in the present of his time and for the future. And Alhamdulillah is the series of the miracles, معجزات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. ذكرت بعضا منها الشجر والحجر يسلمون على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. وذكرت عودا من حطب يعطيه النبي لعكاشة بن محصن. فيصبح سيفا صارما طويلا شديدا أبيضا في يده يحارب به. وشجرة تشق الأرض تمشي إلى النبي تسلم عليه ثم تعود إلى مكانها. وعرجون يضيء أعطاه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لقتادة بن النعمان يضيء أمامه عشرا وخلفه عشرا. He said, I already explained, Alhamdulillah, with a series of the miracles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That the trees and the stones giving salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the stones saying, I know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, I know one of the stones in Mecca used to say to me before the Ba'sa, before I become a messenger, As-salamu alayka ya Rasulullah. Used to say to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, salam, assalamu alaykum ya Rasulullah, before even he become a messenger. Then I moved to just a piece of wood in the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Give it to Ukasha ibn Muhsan. And because Ukasha came to him and he wanted to fight and there was nothing with him in his hand. Then, bibarakati a'ta'u nabi lah, that because of the blessing of Rasulullah, give it to him, just a stick. Become a sword, and is it as it is description in the hadith, sword, and it is very white, celestial, and very strong, and very sharp. In another narration, also for one of the miracles, in mu'jizat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sleeping one time, a tree came near to him, saying to him, As-salamu alayka ya Rasulullah, then came back to its place. Then a lot of other like that. Today, I am going with what I stopped with before. With Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl one time, narrated by Abu Huraira, he said, هل يعفر محمد وجهه بين أظهركم في التراب؟ فقالوا نعم. فقال واللات والعزى لئن رأيته يصلي كذلك لأطعن على رقبته ولو عفرن وجهه في التراب. فأتى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو يصلي ليطأ على رقبته، قال فما فجأهم منه أي من أبو جهل إلا وهو ينكص على عقبيه سريعا ويتقي نفسه بيديه. وقال فقيل له ما لك يا أبا الحكم؟ قال إن بيني وبينه خندقا من نار وهولا وأجنحة. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم والله لو دنا مني لاختطفته الملائكة عضوا عضوا. وأنزل الله عز وجل أرأيت الذي ينهى عبدا إذا صلى. This narration about Abu Jahl narrated by Abu Huraira. One time Abu Jahl said, is there Muhammad mocking at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is still Muhammad putting his face in the dust? He mean about the sujood in the salah. Still he putting some of the dust upon his face while he's praying between you? They said yes. He swear by his ilah, Allat wal-Uzza. If I saw him doing that, I will put my feet over his head. I will put my feet and step over his head. Exactly, he said, over his neck. Then I will smash his face in the dirt. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one time was praying. And Abu Jahl alayhi la'ainullah came in order to do what he was saying to them. Then all of a sudden he was coming back very fast and was full of fear. And he was trying to save himself by his hand. They said, Ya Abul Hakim, what happened to you? Qala, he said, there was between me and him a very big, huge part of fire. And there was a lot of things, I don't know what it is. And there was a lot of wings coming toward me and scared me, make me to go back and to try to save myself. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, by Allah, if he come nearer than this, the angel will take him part by part, will cut him part by part. Then Allah Azza wa Jal revealed the ayah, أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يَنْهَى عَبْدًا إِذَا صَلَّى. Did you see the one who tried to prevent and forbid the one who is praying for Allah Azza wa Jal? This is one of the miracles from Allah Azza wa Jal to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that this is my messenger. Because that miracle for many meaning, one of it confirming that this is my messenger. But Abu Jahl is Abu Jahl. Not only that, in another time in Kutub al-Sirah, in Book of al-Sirah, Abu Jahl said to him one day, you see already, قال Abu Jahl, إن محمدا قد أبى إلا ما ترون من عيب ديننا وشتم آبائنا وتسفيه أحلامنا وشتم آلهتنا. قال أبو جهل وإني أعاهد الله لأجلسن له غدا بحجر ما أطيق حمله فإذا سجد في صلاته فضخت به رأسه فأسلموني عند ذلك أو امنعوني فليصنع بعد ذلك عبد مناف ما بدا لهم أن يصنعوا. فقالوا والله لا نسلمك إليهم أبدا فامض لما تريد يا أبا الحكم. كان يسمونه أبا الحكم. فلما أصبح أبو جهل، وهذه التسمية من النبي، أخذ حجرا كما وصف أبو جهل لهم، ثم جلس لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينتظره. وغدا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كما كان يغدو فقام يصلي. وقد غدت قريش فجلسوا في أنديتهم ينتظرون ما أبو جهل فاعل. فلما سجد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم واحتمل أبو جهل الحجر وأراد أن يفعل ما قال لهم، ثم أقبل نحوه حتى إذا دنا من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فرجع منهزما منتقعا لونه مرعوبا رعبا شديدا قد يبست يداه على حجره حتى قذف الحجر من يديه بعيدا عنه. وقام إليه رجال من قريش فقالوا له ما لك يا أبا الحكم؟ قال قمت لأفعل به ما قلت لكم البارحة. فلما دنوت منه عرض لي دونهم فحل من الإبر عظيم، فلا والله ما رأيت مثل هامته ولا قصرته ولا أنيابه لفحل مثله أبدا، فهم بي هذا أن يأكلني. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: ذاك جبريل، لو دنا أبو جهل لأخذها. This narration, one of the miracles also, and Abu Jahl is Abu Jahl. Instead of the first time he stop and he does not do it no more, no, again. But instead of putting his feet upon Rasulullah, he said, this time I'll bring a very heavy stone and which you barely I can hold it, very big and very heavy. Then I will wait until he start praying, I will put it upon his head. And this is what he promised Quraysh to do. Then he wait to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start praying, he wait until he was in his sujood. Then he try to come near firstly, to throw the stone upon the head of Rasulullah to kill him. Then he said, I saw at that time a very huge camel. And it was coming around me, opening his mouth, want to swallow me. For that I run away and I try to save myself. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say at that time, this is Jibreel. If he come nearer to me more than this, Jibreel will snatch him and will catch him. But not only this side. Look to the miracles in the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. في مسلم والترمذي وفي غيرهما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لأنس بن مالك دعا له واستجاب الله دعائه. فعن أنس نفسه بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال: جاءت بي أمي أم أنس إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وقد آزرتني بنصف خمارها وردتني بالنصف الآخر، فقالت: يا رسول الله، هذا أنيس ابني أتيتك به يخدمه، ونعرف أن أنس خدم النبي 10 سنين، فادعوا الله له يا رسول الله. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: اللهم أكثر ماله وولده فقط. ما قال النبي إلا اللهم أكثر ماله وولده. فقال أنس بنفسه: فوالله إن مالي لكثير، وإن ولدي وولد ولدي ليتعادون على نحو 100، أكثر من 100 ببركة دعاء النبي. وفي رواية الترمذي قال الراوي عنه: وكان له بستان يحمل في السنة الفاكهة 2. نعلم أن بساتين الفاكهة تحمل 1 ببركة دعاء النبي له. كان بستانه يحمل الفاكهة في السنة 2، وكان فيه ريحان يجيء منه كريح المسك. وكل هذا بمعجزة بركة دعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Narrated by Anas, and it is in Muslim and Tirmizi, that Umm Anas, she bring Anas while he was young to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she said, Ya Rasulullah, this is my son Anas, and I bring him to serve you. Only just please do dua for my son. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and who's his dua as we know, one of the miracles also. He said only, Allahumma akthir ma lahu wa waladahu. O Allah, give him a lot of money and give him a lot of kids. Only. Oh Allah, give him a lot of money and give him a lot of kids. Anas himself narrated later. He said, Wallahi, I am the one who have more, I'm most rich one and I have a lot of money as exactly Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. And kid, my kids. And kids of my kids more than 100. Imagine Rasulullah say, Oh Allah, give him a lot of kids only. That he himself saying, my kids and kids of my kids more than 101. Not only that, in another narration of Imam al-Tirmizi, he said that the narrator said that we saw his garden of fruit, tree of fruits, bringing the fruit every year 2 times. Usually any tree of a fruit bring 1 time. And for your information also, usually the trees of the fruit bring 1 year, 1 time, heavy. Second year will find it very little. And then the next year, heavy, 1 year and 1 year. With Anas ibn Malik, every year, 2 times and full. Subhanallah. Bi barakat, with the blessing and with a miracle from Allah of dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Anas, Rasulullah da'a lahu. He did dua for him. Utba ibn Abi Lahab, after he insulted Rasulullah, not only Rasulullah, even Jibreel. زين رسول الله did one دعاء against him. هذا دعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأنس. وقد دعا النبي عكس ذلك، دعا النبي على عتبة لما تلا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سورة النجم، وجاء إلى قول الله عز وجل ثم دنا فتدلى، وهذا يعني جبريل. قال عتبة بن أبي لهب مستهزئا ليس بالنبي فقط ولكن حتى بجبريل، قال كفرت بالذي دنا فتدلى. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم سلط عليه كلبا من كلابك. فكان كلب الله أسدا، كلب الله ليست ككلابنا. النبي لما دعا قال اللهم سلط عليه كلبا من كلابك، من كلاب الله. فكان الذي جاء إليه أسد. خرج عتبة مع أصحابه في عير إلى الشام، حتى إذا كانوا في طريقهم زأر أسد، فجعلت فرائص عتبة ترتعد من شدة الخوف. فقالوا الذين معه نحن معك، من أي شر شيء ترتعد؟ فوالله ما نحن وأنت إلا سواء. فقال إن محمدا دعا علي وما ترد له دعوة، مع أنه يكفر به، وما ترد له دعوة ولا أصدق منه لهجة. فوضعوا العشاء فلم يدخل يده فيه خوفا، وحاط القوم أنفسهم بمتاعهم، وجعلوا عتبة بن أبي لهب في وسطهم وناموا. وانظر إلى المعجزة، جاء الأسد يشم رؤوسهم واحدا واحدا حتى إذا انتهى إلى عتبة وكان في وسطهم، فهمشه همشة أوصلته إلى آخر رمق، وهو في آخر رمق قال للذين حوله ألم أقل لكم إن محمدا أصدق الناس لهجة. سبحان الله، this is one of the miracles from Allah سبحانه وتعالى to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. عتبة بن أبي لهب does not mock at رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم only. He mock even at جبريل. And this is our lesson to every Muslim and Muslima everywhere. Some of us now, they mock at whatever related to Allah or whatever related to Rasulullah or whatever related to Islam. This is completely forbidden upon any Muslim. لا تهزأ بأي شيء يخص الله أو يخص رسوله أو يتعلق بدين الإسلام من أي نوع، حتى ولو لم تكن أنت نفسك مقتنعا به. Even you yourself are not convinced with whatever you see in front of you, never ever look at it. Save yourself. Why? Maybe whatever he is in is right and you are wrong. Then you're looking at sunnah of Rasulullah, or you're looking at something related to Allah, or you're looking at something related to Islam. But if you are a mu'min and true mu'min, if you are, قال الله عز وجل ذلك ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب. Whoever respects the symbols of Allah, it is from the taqwa, it is from the iman, it is from the faith in his heart. For that, out of the iman, you have never looked at anything. And opposite of that also, in order to increase your iman, respect the symbols of Allah. عتبة does not do that. Mocking at Rasulullah as much as he can and fighting against him, and mocking at Jibreel himself. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in Surah Al-Najm, Surah number 53, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said ثُمَّ دَنَا فَتَدَلَّى، then Jibreel, he's talking about Jibreel, approach and come closer to him. Then عتبة doesn't like that. Then he said Allah, he said كَفَرْتُ بِالَّذِي دَنَا فَتَدَلَّى، I become kafir of whatever he of this one, and I disbelieve in it and I don't want it. Mocking at it. Rasulullah, when he heard that, قال اللهم سلط عليه كلبا من كلابك. Oh Allah, send against him one of your dogs. Dog of Allah, different than the dog of the people. When Allah sent dog upon Utba, it was not a normal dog. It was a lion. You know the lion, and actually lion also from the family of the dogs. Or we can say the right way, dogs is one of the family of the lions. Allah sent upon him a lion. Listen to it. One time Utba with his companions going to Sham, and with their camel, the caravan, all of it. Until while they are in their way, they heard the roar of the lion. They heard the voice of the lion. For them all was normal. There is no problem. They know. Only for Utba, he start shaking and he start sweating and he start fear too much. They said to him, what happened to you? The companion around him. What happened to you? We are already with you. You are not separate. He said, إن محمد دعا علي. Muhammad, he did already dua against me. And I know his dua never ever rejected. And there is no anyone truthful in his saying and trustworthy in his saying except him. Even he does not believe in Rasulullah. And this is another miracle in the same. That they know that he is Rasulullah. They know that he is the trustworthy one. They know that he is the most truthful one. They know that his dua is acceptable. And when he knows that Rasulullah said, oh Allah, send to him one of your dogs, he knows that it will happen. For that he starts shaking more. They put the food in order to eat at the dinner. He does not eat. Then, out of protection, imagine it with me, they put the camels with the caravans with whatever the howdah, whatever over the camels, they put it firstly. Then after that, they put their luggage in another circle. Then after that, them themselves, the companions, they sleep around and he become in middle. Look how many things. The camels and the caravans. Then after that, their luggage. Then after that, the companions, the people who was with him, his friends. Then they put Utba in the middle of them. And look to the miracle from Allah Azza wa Jal. They sleep, all of them. The lion came, jumped the first protection, first fence, they think. Then the second one. Then the third one, and he came to them. And he smelled every one of them until he came to Udbayat. This is the one Allah sent to me to him. Then he catch him. Only just one time, it was the end of his life. At the last breath, he said, didn't I tell all of you, Muhammad is the most truthful one in his saying and in his dua? A miracle from Allah Azza wa Jal to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Opposite of that also, for Ibn Abbas, while he was ghulam, while he was very young, دعا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لابن عباس وكانت من المعجزات تحققت فيما بعد في وقته وفيما بعد. قال اللهم فقهه في الدين وعلمه التأويل. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم فقهه في الدين وعلمه التأويل. قال الصحابة فكان أفقه الناس فينا في ديننا وأعلمهم بالتأويل حتى سمي البحر لسعة علمه. ذات is not he did against. He did for also. For who? Ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Abbas. While he was young. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did dua to him. Oh Allah, make him understand the religion. And oh Allah, give him the interpretation of the Quran. Ta'wil al-Quran. Then the Sahaba, all of them, they used to say, إِذَا قَالَ ابْنُ عَبَّاسُ شَيْئًا مَا كُنَّا نَقُولُ بَعْدَ. If Ibn Abbas says something, we do not say, we do not go opposite of him at all. For that here, the Sahaba agreed upon all, that the most knowledgeable one, and the most one who understands the deen exactly as it was revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at his time, was Ibn Abbas. Out of the barakah and miracle from Allah to Rasulullah. Not only that, the most knowledgeable one about the ta'wil, tafsir, interpretations, of the Quran was Ibn Abbas, until they name him the ocean of the knowledge. The ocean of the knowledge, because of very wide knowledge he used to have. Not only in this time, it was in another time also, another narration, Al-Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib, the father of Abdullah, ba'as ibnihi Abdullah ila Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi hajatin, fawajada indahu rajulan, faraja ibn Abbas. هذا ابن عباس لما رأى هذا الرجل مع النبي ولقرب مكان هذا الرجل من النبي لم يفعل ما أمره به أبوه. فرجع ابن عباس ولم يكلم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال في الرواية من أجل مكان هذا الرجل من النبي. فلقي العباس والد عبد الله فأخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بذلك أني قد بعثت إليك ابني فلم يأتك. وقد قال له وقد رأى رجلا معك. فقال أهو رآه هذا رسول الله يقول لعمه يا العباس عن ابنه عبد الله أهو رآه؟ قال نعم. قال أتدري من هذا الرجل؟ قال لا. قال ذاك جبريل، ذاك جبريل ولن يموت. هنا المعجزة، ولن يموت ابن عبد الله بن عباس، ولن يموت ابن عباس حتى يذهب بصره ويؤتى علما. وقد مات ابن عباس سنة 68 هجرية بعدما عمي بصره وصار بحرا في العلم كما أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is a narration another miracle about also ابن عبد الله بن عباس that his father العباس one time send him to رسول الله in some need, something to tell رسول الله, to talk to him about something. Then عبد الله بن عباس came, he found a man was with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم sitting with him. When he found that, he left. He went back to his father. His father went to Rasulullah, complained about that I send my son to you, and he see a man with you, he does not say nothing. Then he left. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, did he see that man? He said, yes, he saw him. He said, do you know who is this one? He said, no. He said, this was Jibreel. Because as we know, Jibreel sometime come to Rasulullah with a shape of a human being. But at that time, even nobody could see him. But Ibn Abbas see him. At that time, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم tell something. He informed his father that your son will have a lot of knowledge and he will not die except if he become a blind. He will not die except after he become a blind. Exactly as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say. First of it, which is he will have a lot of knowledge, was, as I already told you in the other narration, was the most knowledgeable one between the Sahaba, Abdullah ibn Abbas. Not only that, he, before he died the year of 68 Hijri. 68 Hijri. Before he died, he became a blind. Before he died a while, he became a blind. Exactly as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him. أقول قولي هذا وادعو الله وأنتم مؤمنون. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فمعجزات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تعد ولا تحصى، وهي إثبات من الله عز وجل لمن حوله ولمن يأتي بعده أن هذا هو رسولي، أن هذا هو النبي الذي اخترته. فقد كانت كثيرة متعددة، منها معجزته في اللبن مع أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه، ومختصرها أن أبا هريرة رضي الله عنه كان جائعا شديد الجوع ذات يوم حتى أغمي عليه من شدة الجوع، فمر بأبو بكر وقال له ذكرني بآية عن الإنفاق، وهو يعني كما أخبر في حديثه يعني ذكرني بشيء هو يريد أن يذكره هو بالإنفاق. فتلا له أبو بكر الآية وما يعني وما فقه وفهم ما يريد. فمر بعمر وفعل ما فعل نسيم نفسه، ثم بعد ذلك مر به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأخذه إلى بيته، وكان عنده قليلا من اللبن كما قال أبو هريرة لو أعطاه النبي لي ما كفاني وحدي. فلما رآه وفرح به قال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اذهب إلى أهل الصفة فادعهم. وأهل الصفة هم فقراء وهم حوالي 90 واحدا أو 80. يقول فساءني ذلك لأنه لو أعطاني هذا ما كفاني فكيف يكفي 90 من الناس. في سدلك ولكني لم أعصى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، فذهبت فجئت بهم. يقول فوالله ببركة ما في يد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كفانا كلنا واحدا واحدا، وشرب كل واحد منا ملء بطنه. وقال لي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هل بقي من أحد يا أبا هريرة؟ قال لا يا رسول الله، والله ما إلا أنا وأنت فقط. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اشرب يا أبا هريرة، فشرب حتى شبع. قال اشرب يا أبا هريرة، فشرب الثانية حتى شبع. اشرب يا أبا هريرة، وكأن النبي يعلم ما كان في صدره. اشرب يا أبا هريرة، فشرب الثالثة، ثم في الرابعة أو غيرها قال له النبي اشرب، فقال والله لا أجد له مسلكا حتى هنا يا رسول الله. This miracle from رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, summary of it, it was Abu Huraira very very hungry, fell unconscious from no food at all. Then he went in the street, meeting Abu Bakr, asked him about one of the ayah, and he mean by asking him about the ayah of al-infaq, spending fi sabilillah, to remind him, give me something, I am hungry. But he does not get it, and he give him only the ayah. He says the ayah talking about so and so. Then he went by Umar the same. Rasulullah came to him after he was unconscious, and he take his hand and he went to the house. When he went to the house, he saw a little kind of milk, little milk. He felt so happy that there is some milk, at least I will drink. When he saw it and he become so happy, Rasulullah told him, Ya Abu Huraira, go and call the people of Suffa. Abu Huraira felt so sad and bad. If he give me only this for my own self, it will not be enough. How it will be for 80 or 90 people? Ahl al-Suffa 90 or 80 people. Then he said, I never ever disobey Rasulullah. He told me that I went and I bring them. Said, by Allah, every single one of them drank full, completely. And then the second one, the third one, till the last one of them, until Rasulullah said, is there anyone else, Ya Aba Huraira? He said, no, only me and you. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, drink. He said, I drink until I become satisfied completely, full. He said, again the second time, drink more. He said, I drink the second time. Then the third time, as if Rasulullah knows whatever was in his mind before. Because he was saying that if he give me that, he does not say it loud, only just in his mind. Then the fourth time, the third or the fourth time, he said to him, drink more. He said, Ya Rasulullah, there is not any place up till here. There is no any more. I cannot drink no more. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, فَمَنْ بَقِيَ قَالَ أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ فَشَارِبَ النَّبِيُّ وَبَقِيَ اللَّبَنْ كَمَا هُوَ. Then he said to him, who is left? He said, you, Ya Rasulullah. Rasulullah drink, then the milk was as it is. A miracle from Allah. Imagine yourself in a space like that. In a situation like that. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم كفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم توفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم أرحنا وفرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم رب الناس مذهب الباس اشف وأنت الشافي. لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما. أسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفينا، وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين يا حي يا قيوم يا أرحم الراحمين. واهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى، وارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية. وانصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين. وصلي اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.